สวัสดีครับ Good morning once again. This is Kasit Pirom speaking from Bangkok. Today is Saturday, the 6th of the year 2019. The subject matter that I will be speaking to you for the next 10 to 15 minutes is titled Entrenched and Dialogue. Let me repeat the subject matter, Entrenched and Dialogue. This derived from the fact that since the opening of the parliament a few weeks ago, what we have seen on television, what we have heard listening to the radio or to read and to see some of the sayings in the social media, or even to read some of the newspapers and so on, we will see that the Thai political arena is divided into two sides. One the government, the other one the opposition. And the controversies and the mud slinking and so on doesn't confine itself only inside the parliament but also outside the parliament. I think basically the political scene from Thailand is now between the Greens and the Reds. When I say the Greens, I mean the men in uniform, the military government of the past 5 years that has now won the elections through the formation of political party by the name of Palang Pacharat. And on the other side, the opposition is still the Phuea Thai Party, the future forward of Thailand under the leadership of young, inspiring Mr. Thanathorn Chungrungrungkit. So has become the new leadership of the opposition, or namely the Reds. He has become more or less the fourth proxy of Mr. Thaksin Shinawat, the former Prime Minister of Thailand, who still leads the Phuea Thai Party. And before that, the original names of the Thai Rak Thai and Palang Prachachon, and now it's the Phuea Thai. So the political scene of Thailand is no longer the yellow and the shirts and the red shirts, or the multicolored colors under Mr. Suthep versus the red shirts. It's now is the green and the reds, more or less. The green is the not only the military-led government or the military establishment in politics, but the former yellow shirts and the former multi-colored shirts and so on have all joined the military-led government under the leadership of General Prayut Jan Ocha. So the position of the two is quite entrenched. Seemingly, it is one on one side is pro the Kingdom of Thailand. The other side is alleged to be liking the republicanness of Thailand. One is alleged to be pro monarchy. The other one alleged to be anti monarchy. Is it true? And could Thailand continue to see the political arena being entrenched on both sides, accusing and trying to get rid of one another? The military has been in government for the past 5 years after the coup d'etat in May 2014. So they have been had been ruling Thailand for the past 5 years, and they won the elections. So now they are in the government. So the struggle continues between the pro-kingdom and the pro-republican. But is it true? Could Thailand afford to go on like this in a, each side in a very entrenched position inside the parliament and outside the parliament. My idea is that we have to overcome this impasse, this confrontational type of politics. What is my solution? I am proposing that there should be a dialogue. I think General Prayut Chan-o-cha, after 5 years in the government, in the military government, and now in a quasi-democratic elected government, he must reach out to Mr. Thaksin and Khun Thanathorn to have a dialogue. I think a dialogue is very important in order to ascertain each side what are the needs, what are the wishes, what are the displeasures and so on. What are really the thinkings of Mr. Thaksin and his proxy, Mr. Thanathorn? Then one cannot go on living on a sort of a lot of hearsays and allegations that on the that one side is the protector of the Kingdom of Thailand and the institution of the monarchy, and the other side is against the existence of the Kingdom of Thailand and the institution of the monarchy. I think the two sides must sit down as civilized people to talk to one another. And I think General Prayut Chan-o-cha for the past 5 years had failed to initiate the dialogue that would lead to the national reconciliation and a new start for Thailand. But now he is leading an elected government, although quasi-elected government and so on, a quasi-democracy. It doesn't prevent him from reaching out to Mr. Thaksin and Thanathorn and have a civilized dialogue and conversation. What both sides could give and take, what both sides could reconcile, compromise in order to move Thailand forward. We cannot stay in this sort of a confrontational environment which has been occurring for the past 15 years. So that is it's the incumbent upon General Prayut Chan-o-cha, the Prime Minister of Thailand, for the second time to reach out to Khun Thaksin and Khun Thanathorn and have a full dialogue, open-hearted dialogue, in order to find a modus vivendi or a compromise formula in order to move Thailand forward. At the same time, I think the former Prime Ministers, the former Prime Minister, let me emphasize, and some of the eminent persons of Thailand, social thinker like Khun Sulak Sivalak or Dr. Prawet Watsi, these former Prime Ministers and some of the eminent members of the Thai society could initiate a dialogue by themselves. They should get together and have a discussion in order to have some proposals to General Prayut, the Prime Minister, and at the same also to Khun Thaksin and his proxy in the name of Mr. Thanathorn Chongrung Rungkit. So there could be a sort of a parallel undertaking, one by the government itself under the leadership of General Prayut Chan-o-cha, the Prime Minister. The second one is by the former Prime Minister of Thailand and some of the eminent personalities of the society of Thailand to get together, sit down, have a dialogue, and to see what would be the way out for Thailand. We cannot go on living in a sort of very confrontational atmosphere, each one trying to undermine the other. The government is not using the rule of law, but is running the country by the rule of law. See? So that is not enough. You cannot keep on having charges against the opposition. You have to be having a larger heart, magnanimous in your power, and reaching out and have a dialogue. At the same time, the opposition cannot go on undermining the running of the government or the activities of the parliament by being very negative in their approach and so on, obstructive and negative. Then the people get nothing. I think what the people want the government, the cabinet and the parliament to do is to serve them and move the country forward. We have so many problems. Corruption is one, abuses of power or the other. And we also have problems of social inequality. But so far, the past few weeks, we have not heard how the government or the opposition is going to overcome some of the basic difficulties of the Thai kingdom. Because they have been blickering, you know, brinkmanship and so on, undermining each other without due regards to the well-being of the people and to the well-being of the country at large. So it's about time that Thailand has a dialogue, one between the government and the opposition. Second, eminent person, former prime ministers, eminent personalities and so on can get together and have a discussion in order to come up with a set of proposals to move Thailand forward, overcome the impasse, and so that the country can have a better future. Then the people can be served by the government as well as the opposition, so that they can have a better well-being, they can have peace and security, they can have prosperity. I think this is the duty for everyone, the government, the opposition, the former prime minister, the eminent personalities of Thailand. Everyone has to chip in for the goodness and for the prosperity of Thailand. Thank you very much. ขอบคุณมากครับ สวัสดีครับ